Hello my BSKA parents and students. Today I'm just going to make an introduction video about our online academy. Some parents sent us requests to show them how to do it, and because they're struggling or they don't exactly know how to utilize this tool, especially in this time we got for the COVID-19 and we train at home, and how to work through the curriculum and obviously how to prepare yourself for the online grading. So now I'm just going to show you how to use it. It's going to take a bit of a while, a few minutes, a couple of minutes, but I would like to appreciate if you go through this whole video to ensure you understand the online academy. Once you've got set up with your computer or your laptop, you open up your browser. Please remember that this online academy also got an app, so you can use your tablet or your iPhone to go to the online academy. Once when it's open, you type in www.welearnkarate.com. You can also add it as a favorite. Your username will be your registration name, your registration number. That will be your username. Everyone will receive their username and that number you use. Then you will have a password. You will receive a temporary password once you have logged in for the first time, and then you have to put in your own password. Remember, okay, that is what it be. Mine's been saved. So I will just log in. Once logged in, your page will almost look similar to this. And then it's very important. You will see the tabs up here. There's a couple of them, but the most important tab for now we will focus on is My Courses. This is a tab with a drop down. You will see there's a couple of courses here. What will happen, for example, I will show you an example. If you've got a student that's a 10th Q white level 1 or level 2 or level 3, or a senior or a teenager white belt, and then they will need to grade to, depending on their skills and their capabilities, they can grade up to level 2, yellow level 2, full yellow. But that there's a lot of certain aspects that comes involved when we grade students. It's not just about grading who's the best. We must take consideration their age, their capabilities, how long they've been trained, and all of that, and their commitments and stuff like that. So, and how much did they attend classes? Because a person that only attend 50% classes will not know the full curriculum. So what's going to happen is, now if a person is white belt, the courses that will be available for him will be up till orange. He will not be available, the courses will not be available for him for green, blue, purple, and so on. He will need to do the courses up till orange. But I'm just going to show to you how it works. So once you are open up here, you're going to go drop down. We're just going to use one. Say that the person is a white belt or a junior yellow or a 10th Q level 1, 2, or 3, and they're going to grade to yellow 1 or yellow 2. We're going to open up that curriculum. When we open up that curriculum, this page will appear. You will see it will give you the basic line. This is the basic karate line. Basic line is white, junior yellow, yellow, and orange. After that, you will go into the intermediate phase, and then obviously into the advanced phase. Right. To go for yellow belt 1 and 2, your minimum age must be 7 years old. There is some that will go to 6 years old, but we will be very strict on that. But you have to be 7 years old to grade for a yellow belt, yellow 1 and 2. For yellow, you must be done class for at least 4 months, attending 30 classes with 2 credits. The credits works on if you competed in a competition or attended a seminar, like since our Brand Duca seminar, or you've done your Cobra self-defense training camp the one weekend, or you attended the tournament academy. All this will take in consideration and give you credits, because that is additional training that you have done outside the normal class, not attending your two classes per week. But that is how we work on the credits. Now, for you to go to your yellow belt, our main aim is for you to develop Gion and fundamental parts of the karate training, introduction and Kokutsudachi and Gion Kumite. So this is our main aim on this level. So when you scroll down, you will see your Gion curriculum. First, you need to know your karate terms. You will see there's a couple of karate terms there, but it's very important to go to the previous courses also, because there's additional karate terms you need to know. Because when you do your online testing, what I'm going to show you now, you need to know that, because that's going to be part of the questionnaires. So here is your karate terms. Kata means form in English, kumite means sparring in English, mao means destiny. All of these are very important to know. Then you will see there stands Gion curriculum. This means this is your basics. This is exactly in line with how your examination will be to learn. So what's going to happen is, when you look at Semo Gion number one, is Oizuki. That is the front lunge punch. It's in brackets telling you the English version of the name, and this is Japanese. You will also see there's a F and a Z in brackets. That means forward in Zenkutsudachi. That means you have to execute the Oizuki in a Zenkutsudachi stance going forward. So when you put your mouse pointer on the word Oizuki, because you will see it's like a reddish color, there's a question mark coming up. You click with your mouse on the name and another window will pop up. The Oizuki window. So this will actually show you how the Oizuki must be executed step by step. From the one side, from the back, from the side view, where the center of line must be for the punch, how to attack, and all of that. You will see that. And there is also a voice note, how to pronounce it. So this window will pop up, explaining you the Oizuki. We can go to another one, some of the second one, Gion number two, is Agiyuki. The window has popped up for the Agiyuki. It shows you step by step how to execute the Agiyuki, how to practice it. It will show you. Also a voice note.
Agiyuki.
It's very nice how executed. Okay, that gives you idea. So this is your Gion you need to know. It gives you from Gion number 1 till Gion number 7. Then you will see there is Kumite, Gion Kumite. So this is the Kumite they need to do at their grading. So it will actually tell you how to do the Kumite. Moving forward, attacking with Oizuki Jodan. You will see the Jodan is also in color. When you click on the Jodan, the body sections will come up. And it will tell you that is Jodan, that section is Chudan, and below the belt is Gedan. And then it will say the person who will defend will move back, defending with Agiyuki and counter Kyokuzuki on the last block. If you want to see how the Kyokuzuki is, that is the Kyokuzuki. It's the opposite hand to the opposite leg. It's like the Oizuki, but they call it the reverse punch. It's the opposite hand. It's not the same hand, same leg. That is the Kyokuzuki. So once you know that, We also put a video in. We must give credit to Shotokan TV and all of the other videos we embedded in the system, because it all come from the public domain YouTube, and we must give credit to them. This is not our videos. Sooner or later we will replace these videos with our videos, but we are very grateful that these videos are available for our students to be used. You can also follow them. What we have done with the YouTube videos, we found the best ones for us that is closest to our curriculum, that can assist us in this time of the pandemic, the COVID-19, obviously, and then how to exercise and practice at home. So when you click on this video, it will show you how to execute your Guan committee. You can make this videos full screen. You see there, he gets his distance. Moving back in Gadamarai. He had announced 2, 3, 4, 5 encounter. You see there's a Kyakuzuki. Then the other person will get his chance to attack. Okay, just to give you ideas. So there's a video explaining your kumite. Then obviously they need to know their kata. Now to grade for yellow belt, you need to know the first kata, Hain Shodan. This is the meaning of Hain Shodan, and the symbolism of Hain Shodan means earth, chi, earth, land, is a very strong kata. This is slow, this is step by step. Please remember that all these katas would be embedded is not mirror image. So if the person moved to the left on your screen, that's actually in real time, you must move to your right and vice versa. So you must actually look at the same direction as that person. So actually when you have to do it, your back must be to the screen of the laptop or the video or the PC. I've got some students that actually practice the online, but they look and practice it actually in the opposite direction. So once you play this video, it will do it slowly, step by step for you. You will see there's the feet, how to move the feet in the direction, punch, turn around, step through, punch. So that will give you Hain Shodan. This is to teach you the sequence of your kata. Now, when you know your sequence, we also put a video of how the kata must be executed in the correct time and everything, and the correct speed and all of that. So we also got this video is two very good students from Japan. This is to give you an idea how the kata must be executed. Just remember, this kid's been doing karate for 5 years, but it shows you how committed can you be. There is it, very nice. Okay, so this gives you an idea what speed you must execute the Hain Shodan kata. Then you will see we got kata bunkai. This is the application of the kata. Not all the bunkais are all the same. A lot of people got their own variations. I just put this video on for you to see a general bunkai. The application of the kata, the imaginary fight, how they fight with people. Usually we're only one-on-one, but this is how the kata is supposed to be executed, fighting the four attackers. So this gives you an idea of the bunkai. I'm just going to show you quickly the first few steps.
It is essential to understand from where and how you are attacked and to what place you will counterattack. It's most important to know your target.
You can see there's the third move, the grand, the tetsui, step through, and the punch. Mikey forward block, there's an agyuki punch, another one. You will see this last agyuki is not a block, but it's actually a strike. So, there's a lot of variations about the kata, but it gives a student a fair idea what the kata is all about. We will stop that for now. So this is the bunkai. We will sometimes do a different bunkai in the class, but this is to give the student a very good idea of what the Hanshodan bunkai looks like. When you go down, you will see there's a theory test also. Once they click on the theory test, they must do the theory test. They must actually do, when their levels are open, they must complete the previous theory test also, because that all gets calculated. I've attempted 24 times already. Doesn't mean I'm this inside. I work through when I explain it to some people and students. You as a student, you can only have two attempts. So after your second attempt, it will be locked and that will be your final point. So I can go. I've done it earlier, quickly showing someone. So when you click on it and continue, there will be 12 questions. So this, a picture will come up and you must say what it is. You will see there's different, it's ABC. If you can't read the student, you can play him the voice note. There is some of them that doesn't got voice notes. We're busy loading it up. So I'm going to play the correct one.
Yoi Dachi.
That will be fixed because it's actually supposed to be Yoi only, but we are fixing it. So here's another one.
Chuga.
Okay, so it's only Yoi. That is Yoi. So then I must choose the correct one and then I go to the next one. Then I must choose what is one. One is Jordan. Two, the section of two is Chudan. The body section of three is Gedan. So you will go through all the questions on the end. They will a tab will there. They submit your questions. You can review your questions or your answers, and when you finally submit, it will give you your final ones and which ones. If you had anyone that was incorrect, you can try it again. But the questions will not follow the same sequence. This program mix the questions every time you will try attempting your quiz. So when then that is finished, I'm just gonna go back. To the curriculum of yellow belt. So then you got your theory test. Then there's the fitness test. You must be able to do your fitness test. So minimum number of proper push-ups doing is 15 and sit-ups is 20. We are changing the fitness test. We're going to replace the stretching with air squats. We believe the air squats is more important to make the legs stronger. So once you put you click on that, you must click and say that you can do 15 push-ups and 20. What will happen is I will receive a notification that you say you can do that. Then I will go in and I will need to confirm it. I will just show the first one. Oh, Anton here said he could do it. So what I will do is, I will go in and I will then say yes or no. Yes, he can do 15 push-ups. Yes, he can do 20 sit-ups. Yes, he can do his stretching. So if you jump on class, I always have to ask you to do it. I can say no, you cannot do that. So we need to work on it. So that is your fitness test. So this is a quick show to you how your curriculum will look like. Then there's a question and answer. So you can post a question, but it will be to the forum. Remember, there's not such thing as a stupid question. Questions is very important for us. So you can place a question there and we can answer it. The reason why we put it open is for maybe there's someone else that wanted to ask the same question but was feeling embarrassed or doesn't want to ask it. At least the questions is there and they will see the answers. So it's very important to communicate every curriculum on the question and ask answer tab for us. So this will give you your curriculum. But most important to remember, if you go to my courses again, you will see this class training, additional training, and Keon Basics. When you click on the class training, it is actually additional videos for you to train. So you can train with these videos, and it gives you all these kind of videos. I will just show you one or two quickly. Here's a 10-minute total body Shotokan workout. So you can tap on that and you can actually train with these guys online. So it just gives you a little something to do during the lockdown to make your karate better. Additional training is always good. Not just do the curriculum, you need to do other functional training.
Hey guys, to make everything a 10-minute total body workout that uses beginner level Shotokan.
So that's very nice to oefen and follow it with these instructors online.
Okay,
I'm
now
going to go through it and all of it. So that is very good. So there's a lot of them here. Stance practice classes. And we're actually busy also loading up Sensei Jock from Dragon's Dojo in Johannesburg, his videos. So you can also try with his videos.
Okay, today's warm up 30 seconds each.
So you can see that.
Mummy kicks.
It's a 3-minute warm up there. Very nice. We will upload all his videos. What we're also going to do in the class training videos, we have done our Zoom training. So every Zoom will be recorded and also loaded up. This online training platform was not just developed for the COVID-19. It was actually developed, we were busy with it for a year and a half. This is actually an additional tool to our karate school. This is for if you're off sick or you cannot come to class for some reason or you're traveling, you still got access to train your karate. Even during public holidays and all of that school holidays, it's continuous training and develop your skills and knowledge about karate. So this is all put online. This is our student manual. That's actually an ebook manual. So this helps you with your karate online. So obviously when the COVID-19 came up, we fast-tracked it and made it available for everyone. So this will not disappear. It will be still part of our curriculum and additional two. You will then also see there is Keon Basics. This Keon Basics is also videos. We actually put in how to put on your gi, how to tie your belt, because I see a lot of students, some smaller ones, they struggle, but there they can practice at home how to tie their belt, how to make a basic fist and all of that. So here's also videos. Here's Musubudachi. Even if you saw the picture of the Musubudachi, the drawing, here they show you how to do it. This Karate Do Preschool got very nice videos from YouTube. You can go through it. You will also see there's a lot. There's even Oizuki. So you can click on the Oizuki. The commentary video will show you how to execute and practice the Oizuki.
The second punch we're going to move to is called
Oizuki. This sensei is also very good on YouTube.
Is done from our front stance.
He's very detailed. We must give credit to him.
Position. With Oizuki, we step and punch.
It will give you all the basic kyons. We have tried to cover every kyon possible we could find. If it's not there, then we will make the video and we will upload. Sooner or later, all these will be replaced by our own videos. We have some raw videos, but we didn't have time to edit it and upload it. Then you will see additional training videos. Additional training videos gives you also some additional training and what to do, to how to fix up some of the hip flexibility, for especially the hips, very important in your karate, 10 karate training, home exercises. When you click on that, you can train with them. Jesse Enkamp is a very good online karate instructor, very well known, the
in
karate
this video,
net.
You're going to learn 10 karate exercises that you can do at home without a training partner and without a lot of space. Make sure you watch.
So, very good training videos for you. You can go through. Nice one here is the cool stuff, top 4 best karate games. The last one is the one of the best ones. You can download it on your iPhone and everything. Don't let your kids just play the normal Xbox and Sony PlayStation games. Get them this game on their iPhone or tablet, download it, and let them play a bit of karate games. And at the same time, they can learn a bit of the karate names and everything. So these videos is also there as additional videos for you. And obviously with our Zoom classes from next week, with your ebook manual, student manual, we can actually do karate from home. Obviously we're looking forward to be back in the dojo. That is what we cover mostly for the online training. If there's any questions, feel free to email us or contact us. We will explain it for you. I will do another short videos coming soon about the challenge and how we're going to do our online grading. Thank you very much and enjoy.